Well, have your kids taken their ACT, SAT, or PSAT? Which test is best for your child, and how do you decide? Teen expert Dr. Russel Hyken here this morning to talk about it, and good morning to you.
Thank you.
Yeah, I mean, these tests are to evaluate students to predict college success. All of them do that, but they accomplish them differently.
They accomplish them very differently. Mm-hmm. You know, the ACT is a curricular-based test that's based on current knowledge, so what a student actually knows. The SAT is a little different. Not only does it look to assess what a student currently knows, but also potential for future learning abilities by looking at innate reasoning skills and problem-solving skills.
So let's kind of compare the two, the ACT to the SAT, because the ACT is just multiple choice, right?
Correct. It's just multiple choice, and not only that, on the ACT, if you guess wrong, no big deal. You don't lose points for it. But on the SAT, which has a combination of multiple choice, essay, and a write-in math section, well, if you guess wrong on the SAT on the multiple choice, you're going to lose a quarter of a point.
So parents sit there and go, okay, so I mean, how do you know which one's right for your child, or do they take both of them?
Well, you can go either direction in that. So the first thing you might want to do is look at the curriculum that's actually being tested. So on the ACT, you're going to test math, science, reading, and English with an optional essay. On the SAT, you're going to look at math, you're going to look at reading, and required essay, but then there's some optional subject area tests that may be appropriate for a college. The ACT is going to have trig, you know, the SAT doesn't. So those are the types of things I would look at.
How do you know what your college is looking for? Maybe your child's already picked what college they want to go to.
Well, you need to ask the college specifically. You know, it feels very geographical to me. In the Midwest, we typically do the ACT. But when you start to spread out to the coasts, they look at more of the SAT, and some of the more academically rigorous colleges want the SAT as well.
All right. So what if your child's not real good at testing? They get real nervous before a test. I mean, there are options for those students as well.
Right. And every student gets nervous
sure.
before a test.
Yeah.
But here's what I would do. Every student in 9th and 10th grade typically takes the PLAN and the PSAT. These are given by the school to kind of assess ability. And both of those tests line up with their partner test. So the PLAN is the precursor to the ACT. And the PSAT, or PSAT, is the precursor to the SAT. So if you do better on one of those than the other, if you can follow all those letters,
yeah.
If you do better on one than the other, then go with that test.
Okay, so you said there's a lot of options out there.
You know, it's very confusing. And,
yeah.
And now there's a new trend among some of the more liberal art colleges to not even look at ACT and SAT. So there's another wrinkle for you to try and figure out.
Thanks for that. But the colleges who do look at it, just give them a call. Say, which test scores do you go by? Because then you're going to save some money there, too.
Right. Talk to the admissions rep. Go straight to them. Those are the best people to talk to.
All right. Very good. Dr. Russel Hyken, thank you so much for being with us this morning. We appreciate it. For more information on Dr. Hyken and to read his blog on college testing, head to STLMoms.